Good afternoon, everybody. Sorry for this. I just put my presentation in a little bit late. Good morning also to online viewers. So I'm going to talk about, as the chairman said, challenges of high temperature volumetric receivers in CSP. And as the former presenters or speakers were talking about the need to go to higher temperature and for higher temperature storage also, I will focus on a specific type of volumetric receiver, which are atmospheric air volumetric receivers. So this is a special type of power towers. And the first of its kind was built by the Germany. And here you see the solar tower of Jülich in Germany that is using Onicom structures as a ceramic absorber with square channels of 2 millimeters wide. And you can see the air is taken from the outside. So this is atmospheric air and sucked inside the structures. And it is heated because the volumetric receiver is irradiated by this concentrated solar radiation. And they can produce with that high temperature air about 700 degrees C. And with that, they are producing some power with a Rankine turbine, and they have experienced some problems due to flow instabilities, as you can see on the images below, where you see some cups, ceramic cups, that are at a lower temperature than the other due to non-uniformity of solar concentration ratio. So this, I will focus on this technology in specifically, and see and review the challenges needed to increase its efficiency. So as previous speakers have spoke about, we need to go to higher temperatures to reach higher efficiency of the power cycle, and of course make some economic economy and to save the money for building plants, new plants. So there are two options. We can use a gas turbine directly with the air, but it has a low efficiency, but could be used, for example, for dish systems. And it needs a high temperature working fluid. So it can be the air created from and pumped from the atmosphere with this kind of volumetric air receiver. It could also be to preheat at high temperature some working fluid before they go to a gas turbine and then in cascade a steam turbine. So this is a conventional combined cycle. And there are two types of receivers to do that. You can use either a surface receiver or a volumetric receiver. So here you have the main differences between these two types. And here I'm going to focus only on the volumetric receiver. So for the surface receiver, you have the maximum temperature, which is outside the tube. And inside the tube is the heat transfer fluid, which is at a lower temperature than the surface of the material that is heated by the concentrated solar radiation. So it means larger thermal losses and lower efficiency of the receiver. The concept of the volumetric receiver is to cool down the aperture of the receiver, which is responsible for the heat losses. So the efficiency, the thermal efficiency of the receiver should be lower because of the low temperature of the solid in the near the aperture. So to obtain this volumetric effect, which is the fact, I come back on the previous slide, which is the fact that the temperature of the gas at the outlet of the receiver is lower than the temperature of the material in the outlet, and which is responsible for the thermal losses. So to achieve this volumetric effect, two main concepts were given. First, a gradual absorption of radiation inside the receiver, And the second one is using the greenhouse effect. And it's quite a victory if one day the greenhouse effect could help mitigating the climate change. So the greenhouse effect in the volumetric receiver is to use two slabs, a volumetric receiver with two slabs. The first is made with quartz, so it's transparent to solar radiation. And the second is in ceramic and it is black. And it absorbs the incoming solar radiation. But the quartz is opaque to infrared re-radiation, infrared thermal losses from the SiC. And if the quartz is sufficiently cooled down, then the receiver will not emit a lot of energy, so the thermal losses will be limited. And I forgot, this was experimentally shown to present the volumetric effect, and it was also studied with Onicom channels, but only numerically. So, as a reminder of the open volumetric air receiver advantage and drawbacks, here is a list. So, the advantages of this technology is that the working fluid is always available. This is very interesting. It also has good performances under solar transients. It's also very interesting for the operation of the plant. And the low thermal losses are expected if the volumetric effect is present. And also, you have heat transfer fluid, which is at high temperature without a secondary concentrator. The volumetric effect also can withstand high peak flux. This means it's not too sensitive to hotspot. But there are also drawbacks. Because air is not a very good heat transfer medium. It has a low density, conductivity, thermal capacity, and the viscosity increases with the temperature. So this heat transfer fluid, the air, is not useful as a direct storage medium. So we need an exchanger and a high temperature storage for the thermal energy storage. And also experimentally with only one slab, for the moment, the volumetric effect was not experimentally shown. So the main challenges of this technology is to find out the way to obtain this volumetric effect with a one slab, so one material volumetric receiver. And for that, one key point is to increase the convectivity transfer near the aperture to reduce the temperature near the aperture. After that, if this is fulfilled, then the challenges will be to obtain a stable mass flow distribution in the receiver, and then extend the material durability and find some high storage economically viable and also efficient exchangers. So here I'm going to propose and to look at the first point, which is increasing convectivity transfer to reduce the temperature near the aperture, because all the other challenges are depending on it. So previously, Onicom and reticulated porous foams were used as heat transfer high temperature volumetric absorbers. So you can see the geometry, square channels and foams with different porosity and pore size diameter. But today, with advanced manufacturing processes like 3D printing, stereolithography, and others, we can create high temperature material with a complex geometry. And the question we need to ask is this new technology available geometry will help to optimize the combined heat and mass transfer to reach higher solar to thermal efficiency by limiting the thermal losses near the aperture. So this is a first reply, and this has required a chain of software. So here, the numerical study used a computer-aided software to produce complex geometry made of Kelvin cells. Then ray tracing software was used to compute the the solar radiation inside the volumetric receiver, and then the CFD code, a CFD code was used to obtain the flow velocity and the temperature field, and then the some mechanical software could be used. So the main result is interesting, because with this non-optimized structure but complex geometry, we obtain a little numerically, we obtain a little volumetric effect with a temperature difference inside the material, which is about 30 degrees, and an outlet temperature, which is about 1000 degrees C. So now if I gather all the challenges and detail them, so to increase the convectivity transfer, to reduce the temperature near the aperture, what we will need is high-level software that will be implemented in shape optimization procedures. And once we have an optimized geometry, then we will be able to propose the geometry and then develop the corresponding advanced manufacturing processes for the to create the optimized geometry. And after that, we go to experiments, validation, and scale up. And for the other challenges, like a stable mass flow distribution inside the absorber, we'll need a new receiver design, and which will depend on the aiming point strategy, meaning the distribution of the solar flux on the receiver. And it also it depends on the position of heliostar in the field. And for to simulate this receiver, we need new models, and also we will need to go to experimental validation. After that, there will be also need to increase durability of materials, and for the high temperature storage, we will need some cheap materials, very efficient storage, and we also with high temperature exchangers. Okay, so thank you for your attention. And maybe you have some questions.
We have a few minutes for the question. Yeah.
Hi, Cyril. Hi. I have one question. When I see the illustrations in your drawings of the open volumetric, I don't understand if you follow still the some kind of channels, or is fully this kind of configuration, are you preserving some channel, or you
we assume
have a fully open?
This is a fully open volumetric receiver, and the channel in fact is a symmetry condition of the flow for the flow and for the temperature. So it means this is infinitely the pattern here, the geometry is repeated in a Y and X direction, and it only depends on the depth. There is no walls except the structure.
Another question? Okay, thank you very much.